Hello dear students, I am Ganga Bhusle, your statistics teacher. In previous lecture, we have studied about mode and its sum examples. Now, in this lecture, we are going to learn the concept geometric mean. Geometric mean of a set of n observation is the nth root of their product, and this geometric mean is denoted by capital G. Thus, the geometric mean G of n observation xi, I going from 1 to n is given by capital G is equal to x1, x2 up to xn raised to its 1 by nth power. For computation purpose, it is simplified as G is equal to anti-log of 1 upon n summation I going from 1 to n log xi. And for the case of frequency distribution, that is for xi fi I going from 1 to n, geometric mean g is given by g is equal to f1 x1 f2 x2 up to fn xn raised to 1 by capital N power, where capital N is equal to summation I going from 1 to n fi, that is capital G is equal to antilog of 1 upon n summation I going from 1 to n fi log xi. In case of continuous frequency distribution, xi is taken to be the value corresponding to the midpoint of the class intervals. There are some properties of geometric mean. First one is geometric mean of pooled data for two groups. That is, for G1 and G2 are geometric means of two groups of sizes N1 and N2 respectively. Then geometric mean of the pooled data is given by G is equal to anti-log of N1 log G1 plus N2 dot log G2 whole divided by N1 plus N2. Geometric mean of ratio of two series is the ratio of their geometric means. There are some merits and demerits of geometric mean. Uses of geometric mean is construction of index numbers to find the rate of proportion growth and the rate of interest. Now, we are learn about harmonic mean. This harmonic mean is denoted by capital H, and this harmonic mean of set of observation none of which is zero is the reciprocal of the arithmetic mean of the reciprocals of the given values. Then the harmonic mean of n observations xi I going from 1 to n is given by H is equal to 1 upon n summation I going from 1 to n 1 upon xi, which is equal to, when we put out this n from denominator to numerator, we have H is equal to n upon summation I going from 1 to n 1 upon xi. And in case of frequency distribution xi fi I going from 1 to n, harmonic mean H is given by capital H is equal to capital N divided by summation I going from 1 to n fi xi, where n capital N is equal to summation I going from 1 to n fi. Okay. And in case of continuous frequency distribution, xi is taken to be the value corresponding to the midpoint of the class intervals. There are some merits, demerits of harmonic mean. And if H1 and H2 are the harmonic means of two series of sizes N1 and N2 respectively, then the harmonic means H of the combined series of size N1 plus N2 is given by this formula, that is capital H is equal to N1 plus N2 divided by N1 divided by H1 plus N2 divided by H2. Okay. Now, uses of harmonic mean, that is as it has been pointed out in merit 5 above, harmonic mean is especially useful in averaging rates and ratios where time factor is variable and the act being performed. Now, weighted means. This weighted means is denoted by capital W. That is, for weighted arithmetic mean is denoted by xw bar, which is given by summation wi xi divided by summation wi. Weighted geometric mean is given by g वेटेड ज्योमेट्रिक मीन इज डिनोटेड बाय जी डब्ल्यू विच इज गिवन बाय द फॉर्मूला एंटी लॉग समेशन डब्ल्यू आई लॉग एक्स आई डिवाइडेड बाय समेशन डब्ल्यू आई एंड द वेटेड हार्मोनिक मीन इज डिनोटेड बाय एच डब्ल्यू एंड इज गिवन बाय द फॉर्मूला समेशन डब्ल्यू आई डिवाइडेड बाय समेशन डब्ल्यू आई एक्स आई. There are some results. First one is, if A and B are two positive observation, then their arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean is greater than or equal to harmonic mean. And if A, B and C are three positive observation, then their arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean is greater than or equal to harmonic mean. Equality holds when all observations are equal. This is important for MCQ, that is objective. Then if A and B are two positive observation, then the corresponding arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean satisfy this relation, that is geometric mean is equal to under root arithmetic mean into harmonic mean. In other words, geometric mean of A and B is geometric mean of their arithmetic mean and harmonic mean. Then partition values, this is important, that is first one is quartiles, second one is deciles and third one is percentiles. Okay. Quartiles is denoted by Q1, Q2, Q3. The values which divide the data into four equal parts are known as quartiles. Obviously, there will be 3 points because we divide the data in four equal parts. So, we obtain here 3 points, that is Q1, Q2, Q3, such that Q1 is less than or equal to Q2 is less than or equal to Q3, termed as 3 quartiles. Q1, known as the lower or first quartile, is the value which has 25% of the items of the distribution below it, and consequently 75% of the items are greater than it, same as Q2, Q3. In case of ungrouped data, the values have been arranged in ascending or descending order of magnitude. The ith quartile is given by the formula Qi is equal to size of I into n plus 1 divided by fourth observation, where I is equal to 1, 2, 3. And in case of discrete frequency distribution, the value of ith quartile is obtained by considering the cumulative frequencies. The value of x corresponding to the cumulative frequency equal to or just greater than I dot n divided by 4 is the ith quartile. And in case of continuous frequency distribution, the class corresponding to the cumulative frequency just greater than I into n divided by 4 is called the ith quartile class, and the value of ith quartile is obtained by this formula, that is Q1 is equal to L plus H divided by Fk I into n divided by 4 minus Fk minus 1, where I going from 1, 2, 3, where this L is nothing but our lower limit of the quartile class, Fk is frequency of the quartile class, H is the width of the quartile class, and N is total frequency, Fk minus 1 is cumulative frequency of class preceding the quartile class. Now, we are see about deciles. Deciles are the values which divide the data into 10 equal parts. Obviously, there are 9 deciles, that is D1, D2, D3 up to Dn, such that D1 is less than or equal to D2 is less than or equal to up to Dn. Incidentally, D5 coincides with median. The method of computing the deciles Di, I going from 1 to n, is the same as discussed for quartiles Qi, that is I is equal to 1, 2, 3. Then, in case of ungrouped data, Di is given by the formula size of I into n plus 1 divided by 10th value observation, I is equal to 1 to n, when we are arranged this data in ascending or descending order. and in case of discrete frequency distribution, the value of the ith decile is given by the cumulative frequency equal to or just greater than I into n divided by 10 is the ith decile. And in case of continuous frequency distribution, the class corresponding to the cumulative frequency just greater than I n divided by 10 is called the ith decile class, and the value of the ith decile is obtained by the this formula, that is dI is equal to L plus h by f k into I n divided by 10 minus f k minus 1, I is equal to 1 to n, where L is same, f k, h, n and f k minus 1 is cumulative frequency of the class preceding the decile class. Now, percentiles. Percentiles are the values which divide the data into 100 equal parts. Obviously, there are 99 percentiles, that is P1, P2, P3, P4 up to P98 up to P99 last, such that P1 less than or equal to P2 less than or equal to P3 less than or equal to P4 is less than or equal to up to P99. And in case of ungrouped data, this Pi is given by the formula size of I into n plus 1 divided by 100th observation, where I going from 1 to 99. In case of discrete frequency distribution, the value of ith percentile is obtained by considering the cumulative frequencies. The value of x corresponding to the cumulative frequency equal to or just greater than I into n divided by 100 is the ith percentile. And in case of continuous frequency distribution, the class corresponding to the cumulative frequency equal to or just greater than I into n divided by 4 is called the ith percentile class, and the value of ith percentile is obtained by this formula, that is Pi is equal to L plus h divided by f k into I n divided by 100 minus f k minus 1, where I going from 1 to up to n. Same, the values L, f k, h, capital N, f k minus 1. Incidentally, we have P25 is equal to Q1, P50 is equal to D5, which is equal to Q2, P75 is equal to Q3, P10, that is the value of 10th percentile, is equal to D1, P20 is equal to D2, up to P90 is equal to D9. Graphical method of locating partition value, this is our graphical method. Now, we are solve problem number 17, that is find arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean, median, Q1, Q2, Q3, that is quartiles, then D3, D7, deciles and percentiles P15, P70, P85 and P90 for the data 32, 35, 36, 37, 39, 41, 43, 47, 48, 38. This is our solution. First, we construct the table, and in this table for column is our serial number. Here, the value of observation, that is n, is 10, 1, 2, 3 up to 10. Then xi, that is the value of xi, write down the value of xi in second column, that is 32, 35, 36 up to 38. And the total of this xi is nothing but our 396. Then we have to calculate log xi, that is log 32. For the finding the value of log xi, you have to use the logarithmic table, and from the logarithmic table we have the value of log 32, which is equal to 1.5051499978. In this same way, we have to calculate the value of log xi, that is log 35, log 36 up to log 38, which is log 38, which is nothing but 1.5797 83597. Then summation of log xi, that is total is 15.9441618 6. Then in fourth column we have to calculate 1 upon xi, that is the value of 1 upon 32 is 0.031251 1 upon 35 0.02857143. Calculate all the values of 1 upon xi, and the summation of 1 upon xi is nothing but 0.2563904. Then in last column the values of xi, write down the values of xi in ascending order, that is 32, 35, 36, 37, then 38, 39, 41, 43, 47, 48, and the total of ascending order of log the value of xi is our 396. Then here we have to calculate the values of arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean. First we calculate arithmetic mean. Here number of observation, that is n is equal to 10. Okay. Now we write the formula for arithmetic mean, which is equal to summation xi divided by n. Xi divided by n. The value of summation xi is nothing but 396. Divided by 10, which is equal to 39.6. This is our the value of arithmetic mean. Now we calculate geometric mean, that is g dot m, which is equal to anti log of summation log xi divided by n, which is equal to anti log of summation of log xi, which is equal to 15.9441618 6 divided by n, which is equal to 10. When we calculate, we get the answer 39.3213887. Okay. Now harmonic mean. The formula for harmonic mean is n divided by summation 1 upon xi. The value of n is 10, and the value of summation 1 upon xi is nothing but 0.25633, and the answer is 39.01083572. Then here we have to calculate Q1, Q2, Q3 and deciles and some percentiles. Now we calculate median. Median is equal to size of, we know the formula for median, that is size of n plus 1 divided by 2 its observation, n plus 1 divided by 2th observation. which is equal to size of, the value of n is 10, 10 plus 1 which is equal to 11, that is 11 by 2th observation, which is equal to size of 11 by 2, that is 5.5th observation, 5.5th observation, which is equal to fifth observation plus 0.5 into sixth observation minus fifth observation. Which is equal to here fifth observation is nothing but our 38 and sixth observation is 39. Fifth observation is our 38 plus 0.5 into sixth observation is 39 minus 38, which is equal to 38 plus 0.5 into 1, which is equal to 38 plus 0.5 into 1, which is equal to 0.5, then we get here 38.5, that is the value of median is 38.5. In the same way, we have calculate here Q1. Q1 is equal to size of n plus 1 divided by 4, fourth observation, which is equal to size of, the value of n is 10, 10 plus 1 divided by 4th observation, which is equal to size of 10 plus 1 which is equal to 11 and 11 divided by 4 which is equal to 2.75th observation. Which is equal to here 2nd observation plus 0.75 into 3rd observation minus 2nd observation. Okay, now what is the value of 2nd observation? Here 2nd observation is our 35 and 3rd observation is 36. 2nd observation is our 38 35. Plus 0.75 into third observation is 36 and second observation is 35, which is equal to 35 plus 0.75 into 36 minus 35, which is equal to 1, which is equal to 35 plus 0.75 is nothing but 35.75. Therefore, the value of Q1 is equal to 35.75. In the same way, you are calculate Q2, Q3, deciles D3, D7, P15, P20, sorry, P70, P85, P90. Okay? I hope all of you understood the concept geometric mean, harmonic mean and the respective first one example. In next lecture we solve some more example. Okay.